Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Eno Rita James. In my channel, I try to look for ways that can make your sewing life easy. In my last video, I talked about a completely free pattern making software called Pattern Maker Pro. It's a completely free online pattern making software. I introduced you to that particular pattern making software and have the link directly below this video. In this video, I'm going to be talking about how you can make a digital basic body block using Pattern Maker Pro. There are a lot of videos on how to make basic body blocks manually online. I even have a lot of videos on it and how you can create your basic blocks manually. But let's say you want to learn how to do this faster and how to do it online and how to do it digitally. And you're a beginner. This is the best video for you. So let me show you how you can create your basic block very fast using an online pattern making software called Pattern Maker Pro. The very first thing we need to do, of course, is to get to Pattern Maker Pro. And once you put that on your Google, it takes you here where you see Fearless Makers and you click on it. And it takes you to your account. If you've not opened an account with Fearless Makers, I mentioned it in my last video and I'll put the link directly below this video. All you need is an email address and, of course, a password. That's all you need to open an account with Fearless Makers. Once you get here, if you get to your account, this is what you're going to see. Now, if you come down here, you click on measurement sets, because that's the very first thing we need to do. At least you need to put your measurements here to be able to create the basic body block. I already have a measurement here with my name right here. You can choose either way to put in your measurements. You can decide to click plus here to create a brand new measurement. That means you just put in your name. Let's say I put in my name there. Choose a unit of measure. Click on this drop down and choose centimeters or inches, whichever one you want to use. Then create sets and enter measurements. So this is what you're going to be doing. Across back, once you click on it, it shows you how you're going to do the measurements and just put it there. It's as simple as that. If you look at this place, you see the way to do the measurements and put it, your ankle, arm, everything. Once you click on this empty space, it shows you how to put in your measurements. So you can either go that way or you can go the way that I did. For me, I just went straight to this measurement set. If you click on it, it will open up different kinds of measurement sets that you want. You know, like I went for this MD female avatar, different kinds of female avatar. You can also choose from any of these sub menus. Like if you're creating a block for an infant or a child plus, an adult young male, matured male, adult young female, matured female. For me, I clicked on this. And when you click on it, you actually see measurements here. What I did is to look for measurements that is similar to my measurements so that I won't have to do too much work on it. And that is how I came up with my own measurements, like this adult mature X female. This particular one, clicked on it. Once it takes you here, you can now change and put in your name. Adult mature X female, I put in my name there. That is how I know that that's the one I want to use. So either way, you can use any of the measurements
that any way, any method to be able to put in your measurements. Once you're done with putting in your basic measurements, you're going to have your measurement set appear here. So whatever measurement set you put, for you or for a customer or whoever, it will appear right here once you click on measurement sets. So once you're done with that and you find that your set is here, you can download it and work with it if you want. You can adjust or edit these same measurements. Maybe you grow thinner or you grow fatter. You can decide to change one or two things right there on your measurement by clicking this icon. So once you have your measurement and you're satisfied with it, you just come up here to Pattern Maker Pro and then go to Garment Patterns. Here we see all the slopers that you want. Adult male, adult female. So this is the one that we want to be creating. Or this one. So it depends on you. Do you want this as short from your top to your waist? Or do you want a sloper that is full up to your just before your hips? So it depends on whichever one you want. But for me, I want to go for this because I'm going to also do a skirt basic block. I also do a skirt. So it depends on you. Choose whichever one that you want. Yeah? For me, I want this one, fit 11. So I will just click on it. And once you click on it, it will tell you to choose your measurement set. Remember, we have put our measurement set already. So you just click that, and then this is the measurement set I want to use. And once you've done that, just click on Add to Basket. As you can see here, it shows you your block. This is what you're going to get. You're going to get a back, a front, and a hand body block for this. So just click on Add to Basket. And once you click on Add to Basket, it will ask you whether you want to add another thing. Let's say you don't want a long hand for your basic block. You want a short hand. You want a puffed hand. Once you click on that, it will just automatically change and give you a puffed hand. But I don't want any of that. So I'm just telling you that for information if you want. I just want to create a basic block with, a long sleeve and all that, that I can adjust whichever way I want. So as you can see, you can change whatever neck you want. Once you click, you just change it automatically to what you want. So this is just what I want. So I'll just go to Draft and Output. Variables, you can decide to change it, but I advise you to just leave it as it is. Then go to Output. That's all. That's all, my people. So you can download it as you want. You can download your front, your back, and your sleeve. You can download it as PDF and all that. I'm going to download them as PDFs, and then I'll print them out, and then we'll put them together. So I've downloaded them all. This is my sleeve sloper, my body sloper back, body sloper front. So let's take a look at what it looks like. This is the sleeve. This is what it looks like. It has about 6 pages of A4 paper. This is what it looks like. Okay. Let's look at the back. It also has 6 sheets of A4. That is what it is. And of course, the front. So that's the front. 666. So I have about 18 sheets of paper to print. So once you've printed it out, if you go to this Pattern Maker Pro, if you go to the manual, there's a place that you look at how to assemble your patterns. That's it. So once you download it and print it out, You come here and you look at how to assemble it together. Totally shows you how to assemble it, where to cut, how to add everything. And this is where I went to be able to assemble mine together. That is essentially how easy it is. I told you that it is very easy to do. Once you, you know, downloaded it, printed it, you have your basic block that you can use and adjust to get whatever pattern you want. You could also do it manually. You could also do it using the fashioner if you want to adjust the patterns to create different styles. That's how simple it is, really. The only time you might spend it's in putting in your measurements, because there's quite a lot of measurements, and also putting the papers together. Apart from that, you get something very, very accurate. Very, very accurate, I must say.
So these are the three printouts. I have here the basic body sloper front. I have here the full fit body sloper back, and of course the one piece sleeve sloper. I'm going to show you how to put together just one part, then using that same method you put together this one and this one. If you look at the papers closely, you see that they have a circle. Let me see. So that it has a circle like so, and it has an alphabet. So right now you have A1, you have A2, you have B1, B2 to B3. So just take note of the circles around it, the circles, and of course the alphabet. And that's just how we are going to place this together. According to our instructions, you're supposed to cut off as you place, but I discovered that using just those circles is faster and easy, which I'm going to show you. So you did a sellotape, of course. So the first thing, let's take A1, let's take A2, keep that aside. So what I'll do, I'll just place this first paper down, place the second one, and ensure that the circles at the sides match. I think I should keep it like this to look better. So as long as those circles match, everything is okay. The circles match. Then I get my sellotape, and I just gum it together. So that is A1 and A2 joined together. As you can see, as long as those circles match, for me, it's faster. So I'm just going to put A3 at this edge also. So I've added all the A's, as you can see that. I've added all the A's, three rows. The next one is to add the B's. So I've added the B1 there, and ensure that the circle here matches. Are you seeing what I'm doing? Let me shift it a little bit. And ensure that this circle here matches the circle on A1. Just matches it. See, everything falls in place. And the same thing goes for here. The circle matches that circle. So I'll just put my sellotape along here to join it together. And I'll do the same thing for B2 and B3. So that is the front piece of my block. I finished joining everything together, as you can see. So all I need now is to use the scissors and then just trim it out. And that is the fitting. After holding the dots here and the dots here, that is the fitting. It's not too bad. It's not even bad at all. It's exactly my body. So with this video, now I've come to the end of showing you how you can create your basic body block using an online pattern making software called Pattern Maker Pro. I hope you try your hands on it, and when you do, drop your comments if you have any challenges, and let me know how your basic body block turned out. Thank you so much for watching. Till next time in my next video.